NASA is about to test launch a flying saucer over the Pacific. It's part of a plan to get us to Mars. WESH 2's Dan Bello explains how this flying saucer is different than the ones you've probably seen in the movies.
We may have to change the way we think of flying saucers, because the one NASA's building won't fly sideways like this one or like the ones in the old movies. And unlike those movie flying saucers, it won't be coming from Mars, but it may help get us to Mars.
Flying saucers have invaded our planet.
Our planet has never built a flying saucer, but NASA's working on this one in Hawaii that's about to fly.
I suppose it does have a little resemblance to a flying saucer, though it doesn't fly like you see in the movies. It flies this way.
The saucer is not a complete spacecraft, but it's part of one. It's what will allow a landing on Mars someday on a mission launched from the Cape. From Hawaii, a giant balloon big enough to fill the Rose Bowl lifts the saucer to 120,000 feet. Up there, the saucer's rocket fires and accelerates it to 4,000 miles an hour. They've tested it on a rocket-powered sled on the ground. A big inflatable ring 15 feet wide inflates at high speed. That would slow down a landing spacecraft from thousands of miles an hour so it could touch down. A huge parachute is also part of the package. NASA has to test this at extremely high altitudes above Earth because up there the air is as thin as it is on Mars. It's an accurate test. So far, we've landed a rover about the size of a Mini Cooper on Mars. To land something bigger, we need a bigger braking system like this one.
By some studies, we need something on the order of a two-story house to be able to land on Mars.
The launch of NASA's flying saucer from Hawaii is as early as tomorrow morning. At the Kennedy Space Center, Dan Bilow, WESH 2 News.